grateful beings. King Akbar appreciated Birbal's wit and intelligence and liked to challenge him once in a while. Today was one of those days. He made a strange request to Birbal.
Birbal, I want you to get me two living beings. One must be a grateful one who is ever ready to show his gratefulness and return it. Another one should be someone who takes the favors for granted and is never satisfied.
Yes, Jahapana. Tomorrow, I will bring them to court with me.
Next day,
Jahapana, here are the two beings that you asked for.
Okay, Birbal. Explain the reasons to me.
This is my dog, Sheru. He is a grateful being. I give him merely a piece of bread every day, and in return he protects my house from burglars. He is always happy to see me. A dog always remembers the one time you would have fed him, even if you would have shooed him away the next time. The dog will be grateful for that one time and become a faithful friend. It will recognize you wherever you are and will come at once if you call out to it.
What about the other?
This is my son-in-law. He receives gifts and favors from me, the bride's father, all his life. A wealthy father would empty all his treasures, but a son-in-law is never satisfied. He expects favors all the time. He is grateful for a moment, but then takes it for granted. He thinks his position entails the gifts.
You are quite right, Birbal. I agree with you. Now I sentence this son-in-law to death for his ungratefulness.
Jahapana, I was not talking of my son-in-law in particular. All sons-in-law are generally like this. Are you going to sentence all of them to death? Also, Jahapana, you must not forget that you too are a son-in-law.
Hearing this, the king and the courtiers burst out into laughter. Once again, the king was impressed with Birbal's wit and intelligence and pardoned the son-in-law.